Now, I'm going to be tying a tarpon bunny. Now, the tarpon bunny comes in many colours and sizes. I mean, this is the large chartreuse one that I've tied. Yeah, there's white and grey, black. The nice colours these. And orange and yellow. I mean, lots of colours, a natural colour. And this one here. The one I'm going to be tying is basically this one here. It's just a sort of version of a, in this case, the colour. The colour's called Fire Tiger. It's a nice colour combination. Now, these are only about 10, 12 centimetres long. Between that sort of size that I've been tying, the hook size or the hook I'm going to be using is this one here. It's just from my stud. There's many hooks you could use. This is a 1-0. Nice, strong, really sharp point. So it's a good strong hook. You could use a lighter one. This is one of the smaller sizes I've been using. This Mustad here, the C70S. It's a size 2. So basically, it's entirely up to you. You pick the hook that you prefer, or what you recommended, which is always, if you're going somewhere, I would certainly ask what type of hook they would recommend for the type of fish you're going to be catching. Obviously, this is for tarpon, but though it can catch many other fish, it's a good style. The bunny basically, it's obviously a strip of rabbit at the back. Now, I've tied many more with hackles the same, so you can do variants of it. So just going to tie a version, just messing around with colours. Purple's a good colour, black obviously. It's just entirely up to yourself. Then I'm going to put a layer of thread down, and this is a UTC thread, and the colour on this one is a fluorescent fire orange. So I'm just going to take the thread to them in line with the point of the hook, and then remove the waste. Just tidy that wee bit up. Now to support, if you look here, this one I tied purposely. If you look how the tail just hangs 90 degrees from the hook, there's basically not a lot of support at the back here, so this will tend to get a bit of tail wrap. Now, stopping tail wrap using like a Rapallon type knot will help in a fly like this. But if you want to support it, like you can, now we'll see the white one here. You've got just a tiny bit of bucktail under there, under the tail, and that's helps support, stops the tail wrap. So this one I'm going to do, in this colour, this fly, I'm going to use a hot orange. Turn away, tie it in, looking around probably twice the hook shank over the back. Just going to catch this in two or three turns. I want to taper the head, so I'm going to taper cut into the bucktail. It's quite stiff, this bucktail, and that's what you want, because it's to support the tail. Now what I'm going to do is just pinch them together and press and take the thread up. Start to come back down. Now I've only just put loose turns over the top of the bucktail. So what I'm going to do, touch of super glue on the way back down. I'm going to tighten up, tie these in, so this will secure it in really, really well. Just make your fly last that bit longer. Flash, could be lots of flash, could be red, orange, different colours, or you could just leave it out. I'm just putting a bit of orange crystal flash in. Pulling these ends together. I've got about four strands here. Sit on top. Now, for the tail, I'm using this one here, Jailhouse Sonka strip. That's Fire Tiger, as you can see. It's a lovely colour. Now I've got a length cut here. Now this measures, I'll just get the exact measure. Now I'm looking around about 10 centimetres or so. It's worthwhile measuring and getting the length in these, and I just use them against the ruler, so that's about right. Just set this on the top. Now I've cut it into a point so I can get a nice taper. Gets this on, two or three turns just to secure it, just to see how it's going to sit. That's fine. Again, just quickly take the thread up. Just as you get towards the tip, they'll tighten up a bit more. Just want to flatten this down. And then a wee touch, again, super glue. Come back up, screwing this in. Take away the excess. You see how that supports the tail? Sits really well, keeps it up. Now, for the hackle, I'm going to use the same Zonker strip. I'm just going to catch this on the side and tie it down nice and tight. Now, wind over some super glue, so that basically makes it really strong, tight. Then we just wind this one like it was a hackle. Nice and tight. Draw it back. Skin sticks to the super glue instantly. It really is strong. That's fine. Now this hackle, it's not that very thick, so that's why I'm going to put a couple of hackles on this colour. Sometimes you don't need to get a good rabbit fur that it doesn't need anything in front. And this probably you could get away with just leaving it the way it is. There are a few turns in there. Now I'm going to cut this at an angle, so I got a taper cut. So pull this back, just moisten your fingers and then draw back the rabbit. It's easy to do that, easier to control the fibres by doing that. And then we just make sure this is secure, nice and tight. You see it helps to keep the taper all the way up. UTC 140 covers really well. You see how it sits, very mobile. As you can see, and that's pulsating. Now you can put a hackle on the front, obviously I've got two, I've got orange and yellow here. I only want a couple of turns. I've got just, these are large cork hackles actually, but they're off a Chinese, so they're quite soft. They're not that, they're too stiff anyway. So I put both feathers together to time it at the same time. So trim, get it on the side, nice and tight. As I say, I'm only going to put a couple of turns, I'm not going to go crazy. So I'm just going to fold the feather, the fibres back. Let's do it. Just follow this up, put a 90 degree bend into the feathers, and then come across with the thread, making a space so that you're tying in the stem. You're not catching in too many of the hackle fibres. Okay, I'm just going to trim this away. Any fibres that's left, we can draw them back. And again, we can tidy the head area up. And then come back up. We're just using the UTC like a floss. So it's just a fine floss. See how it's sitting. That looks fine. Now I'm just tidying this area up. Take the thread back down and whip finish. And that's basically the fly tied. Now you can put eyes on it, and as you can see, maybe you might have noticed on my finger, I've actually got two white eyes. What I'm going to do here is, but we touch this, I'm going to put it on basically the side of the hackle. So I'm going to make sure the hackle's out like this, so there's like a space. I'm just going to wee touch of super glue there. Got a pair of tweezers. Just going to position the eye where I want it. Press. Nice and tight. Just like that. Do the same on my side. Make a space for the eye. Wee touch of super glue. Don't need much, pair of tweezers, put the eye in there, press, just check they're okay, they're in line. It's nice and tight. There we are, that'll hold it. And then what I'm going to do is then use a UV, a resin. I'm using a regular resin, this one, a classic from Gulf. It's a nice one. It's I like the wee applicator, it's easy to apply the resin. So what I'm going to do is just put it on. This is, the regulars are quite heavy, so you can work it. Just put it on the head first, all the way around. If you can rotate the vise, it's easier to apply. That's enough on there. And then I'm just going to take it up onto the eye, just lightly. Do the same on my side. So then they come one. Lid on. I like to rotate the vise well so it doesn't go to one side. Then we just set the resin all the way around. And there we are. Just one of the many colour combinations you could tie these in. And these would be ideal for pike as well. Certainly pike would have a go at something like this. There we go. I like to coat the resin with a fine coat of normal varnish, even onto the eye, all the way around. And that's it finished.